Good afternoon, everyone. A very warm welcome to you on behalf of the Fikki Flow Pune chapter. With us is our very special guest for today, Mrs. Riddhi Behel, AFLO member Kamini Sanghvi. To take us through this webinar, I'd like to hand over this virtual platform to Dr. Anita Sanas, Chairperson Flow Pune. Over to you, Anita.
Thank you, Sonia. Good afternoon, Flow Pune members, Flow members Pan India, and friends watching us live on Facebook right now. Today, we have a speaker who will be giving us information on a topic that interests all of us, and that is Vastu. The benefits of Vastu and how, with little changes made, we can improve the energy of our place for getting maximum benefit for peace, love, harmony, and prosperity. Welcome, Riddhi Behel. I'm sure everyone is eagerly waiting for your talk. So welcome to our webinar. Our day chair for today is our own Flow Pune member, Kamini Sanghvi. Kamini is a homemaker involved in many creative and social activities. She is the founder and charter president of Inner Wheel Club of Pune Riverside, and also is a naturopath. Her family business, the Sanghvi Group, includes My Glam beauty brand and India's largest luxury spa company under the Lostan brand. Welcome, Kamini, to this as a moderator, as a day chair for this event. I hand it over to you.
Thank you, Anita. Hello, everyone. Astrology, palmistry, numerology, and Vastu are such topics in which I'm sure most of the women are always keen to know and understand the science behind it. Every woman has a dream to have a beautiful house with positive vibes around. Beautiful house, of course, anyone can make, but can that place bring happiness, health, and wealth? To understand the science and logic behind this, today we have Riddhi Behel with us. Riddhi Behel is a celebrity astrologer and Vastu consultant. She is the great-granddaughter of India's renowned astrologer, Pandit Madhusudan Ojha, who was the counselor to Raja Mahadev Singh Ji, the king of Jaipur. Continuing her family legacy, Riddhi got into astrology and Vastu and did her PhD in both. Today, she is well known as one of India's leading astrologers. Her TV shows on ZTV, Aaj Tak, Indian News, and Sahara Samay are widely watched. One can read her predictions and articles in newspapers and magazines like The Economic Times, The Pioneer, Deccan Herald, Amar Ujala, Outlook, Women's Era, and many more. She is on board as a Vastu advisor to some of the leading builder group across the globe. One can see her advice on relationship, marriage, career, and education, health, finance, residential, and commercial Vastu. Her way of practicing the subject is completely scientific and logic-based. She has delivered number of talks on scientific aspects of subjects on platform like Fikki, CII, IMC, Women Economic Forum, and many more. She was awarded as the best astrologer for the year 2015, apart from the Nari Samman Award and the Women Ovator Award, to name a few, and was felicitated by the President of India, Sri Ramnath Kovind, in the year 2018 for her contribution in this field. Riddhi, now our members are anxiously waiting to hear you. So tell us, how did you get into Vastu?
Okay, so Anita ji, as you had just mentioned that, you know, my great grandfather, he was astrologer to the king of Jaipur, and this gentleman had written some 200 books in his lifetime on astrology and astronomy. So the atmosphere you're brought up in has a deep impact on you. So, you know, I would see from my childhood that, you know, scholars would come to our house, you know, there would be discussions on his work. So astrology and Vastu was not something like, you know, a Panditji will come in your house and say, wear this ring or put this tika or do this, you know. It was, you know, something very high, something very respected. So that was always there at the back of the mind. But then I went ahead and did my MBA from Symbiosis Pune. So there the Pune Connect is there. Then I was with the corporate sector for many years. And then it was, you know, after my son was born in the year 2002, I had some very serious illness, very serious health issues. And, you know, that was a time when I was kind of, you know, I was pretty young and I was very confused and, you know, very unhappy with the situation which is around. And that was a time when I really got hooked on to astrologers. And I kept asking, why did this happen to me? You know, that phase of why me happened. Anyways, then to cut it short, then, you know, but I was not able to get the correct answers, the questions that I was looking for, you know. So then this idea came to me that why don't I get into it myself? And that is how, you know, the journey of, you know, astrology and Vastu started.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Vastu is completely scientific and logic based. How does it work?
Yes. See, everything in this universe, including you, me, the plants, the animals, everything is made of the five elements, right? We all know, which we call as Panch Tattva. Now, a structure, it can be your office or your residence or any structure, you know, also has an impact on these five elements. Whenever there is an imbalance of any of the element in a structure, then we call that as Vastu Dosh. Now, Vastu and astrology both are called as Vedang, means part of the Vedas. Vedas are the oldest scriptures and they are very logical and very scientific. You know, Vedas basically talk about our duties and responsibilities towards ourselves, towards the society, towards our family. Astrology and Vastu also is a part of that, you know. Ayurveda, which talks about the physical well-being of we individual. I'm sure you all must have heard this term, Kapha, Vata and Pitta. In Ayurveda, they say whenever there is an imbalance of any of this Kapha, Vata or Pitta, it leads to health issues. So what is Kapha? Kapha is water. What is Vata? Vata is air. And what is Pitta? Pitta is fire. So again, it comprises of three elements, right? So same way, like when there is an imbalance of any of the element, it leads to health problem. Same way, whenever there is an imbalance of any of these element in a structure, it leads to Vastu Dosh. Now, talking about the scientificness of the subject, I'll just explain you with the help of an example. In our human body, heart is a very important organ of the body. Heart is not situated in the center of the body. Rather, it is situated 3/4 above the body, right? Up in the body. The veins which travel from the heart to the brain are very fine veins compared to the veins which travel from the heart to the legs, right? That means the blood flow of which goes from the heart to the brain has to be really, you know, measured. You know, even an extra drop of blood can lead to, you know, serious health issues or brain damage. Now, Earth is a magnetic ball. You know, we have two poles, North Pole and South Pole. These two poles are the areas, are the, you know, center of the magnetic energy. When you become anemic, what does the doctor says? Doctor gives you iron pills, right? Says that your body is deficient of iron. That means our blood contains iron. Earth is a magnetic ball, right? It is said, you must have heard, it is said in Vastu that you should not be keeping your head towards north. You should be keeping your head towards south. I'm explaining this. Why do they say so? Because if you keep your head towards north, from the northern pole, which has lot of magnetic pull, when you'll keep your head towards that, what will happen? The magnet will pull the iron. So the flow of blood from the heart to the brain will be more. And as I said, even a single droplet, extra droplet of blood reaches your brain, it can be disastrous, right? So that's why it is said that you should not be keeping your head towards north. Now, why north? You said even south is a pole. Then why not? Why do they say not to keep your head towards south? Because we are living in the northern hemisphere. People living in the southern hemisphere should follow this, that they should not be keeping their head towards south. So this, you know, explains that why should we not be keeping our head towards north. So like I explained you, this one simple principle, each and every principle that we follow in Vastu has a reason or a logic behind it. So this explains that, you know, how scientific it is. See, when astrology and Vastu was written some 5,000 years back, there was nothing like, you know, crystals, pyramids or remedies. You know, it is now, especially in past 30 years, ever since the advent of TV has happened, you know, we see all those, you know, shows where those funny Babaji's are recommending, ye kar lo to ye ho jayega, ye kar lo to ye ho jayega. See, nothing like this happens. But there is a solution to each and every problem. only that you have to get into the depth of it. Problem is what? People don't try to get into the depth of the problem. And as a result, what do? They give do these marketing gimmicks of putting this pyramid or crystals. Believe me, these things don't work. But then yes, Vastu and astrology, which is absolutely a science, works 100%.
Very true. So tell me, does Vastu help in solving our day-to-day problems in life?
Absolutely. Absolutely. It helps in solving our day-to-day life, right? Like, see, what are the day-to-day issues or what are the issues that we face in our life? You know, health is one of the issues. In a house, in a family, harmony is one of the issues. If you are in business, you know, your profitability is one of the issues. Opportunities, children's education, you know, these are the factors which our lives revolves around. You know, with every age, okay, the situation changes, but broadly, we all, you know, want happiness, financial stability, harmony, love, affection, relationships to be good. And Vastu has wonderful, you know, remedies. And believe me, ma'am, these remedies are very simple and very easy to do. Generally, people have this perception that, you know, it is Vastu that would require some structural change or, you know, I have to make some big changes which would involve big money in it. No, it's not like this. Like I said, you know, you need to get into the depth of the problem. If you get into the depth of the problem, there is a solution to it. Like, I'll give you a small and a simple example. North. North is the direction for health and opportunities and also money. And North, we associate with water element, right? Kehte na paisa paani ki tarah chala jata hai, to paise ko hum paani se equate karte hain. As I said, North is the zone for money. Also, it is the zone for opportunity and growth and good health. Now, what is the color of water? It is blue, right? And element is water. Water and fire are enemies, right? Now, if in your north direction, you get a fire, you know, element, that can also be anything of red color. Suppose you have a living room in the north direction and the color of the curtains or the colors of the upholstery is red. That means in the north direction, you have got fire element. Now, how will it impact you? There will be health issues. There will be monetary issues. There will be opportunity issues, right? So just by changing the color of the room or the sofas, etc., you know, you can really, you know, balance things. So this is simple. I'll give you a simple tip here also today. Since, you know, we past few months have been really stressful for all of us and, you know, especially financial issues, I'm sure we all are facing. So to attract money in the north direction of your house, put a green water bottle or a green bottle, a green glass bottle, and put a money plant in it. It will attract money. So I'm sure today after the session, all of you are going to go and buy a green bottle, right?
Yes.
So like this, you know, there are so many other things. Like, I'll give you another example where there was this client of mine and they were jewelers. And they said, you know, everything is happening. We are getting, you know, good clients and, you know, we are selling good stuff. We have a very good reputation, but recovery of money is not happening. You know, people take money from us, but then, you know, we are not very regular as far as the payments are concerned. And with, you know, all we business entrepreneur women here, this is a very, very big issue, recovery of money. So, you know, I kind of visited his store. And as I said, south is the direction for fire. Like, north is for water, south is the direction for fire. And southeast direction is the zone for recovery of money, which is fire. Kitna paise ki aag lag rahi hai, matlab paise kamane ki aag lag rahi, you know, that desire, that fire in you to do something, to earn money or make yourself, you know. So that is fire. So what I found out was that in his southeast direction, the water dispenser was there. I did nothing. I just shifted the water dispenser from the southeast to the north direction and his problem was solved. So, you know, simple things like this can really bring about miraculous changes.
Yes, I do agree.
Yeah.
It's just the awareness of the right direction and right placement.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So when we talk of property, it's either commercial or residential.
Yeah.
What is commercial Vastu and how is it different from residential?
Yes, absolutely. See, in residence, in a house, what is that you want? You want, as I said, you want harmony, you want peace, you want the family to be together, right? Whereas in a commercial place, what do you want? You want your business or your profession to grow. You want more profitability, right? So there are certain rules for commercial vastu. Now, when we check commercial vastu, we need to see what is the profession of a of yours. You know, say for a chartered accountant, you know, the directions will be different. Whereas for a jeweler, for example, the directions would be different. Like yesterday, I went and did vastu at somebody's place and they are into manufacturing of food items, you know. So for them, the direction would be different. So commercial vastu is different, depends on what is your profession. Like somebody like a lawyer or a chartered accountant or a consultant, you know, you need to speak more, you need to talk more. Right. So northeast, which is the direction for Jupiter and Mercury, because Mercury is the planet for communication. So if that person sits in the northeast and gives consultation, you know, his advices would always be taken very positively. Right. Like as I said, for jewelry or for anything like, you know, anything like cosmetics or beauty, you know, then southeast, because that is the planet which is ruled by Venus. Venus is the planet for beauty, for glamour. So if you have a, say, jewelry store or a cosmetic brand, if you have a southeast entry, it will do wonders to you. Right. So this is how it works. Whereas for residential vastu, you want the family to be together. Like again, for you, harmony in the family, I'll give you an example. They say a place is haunted. When is a place haunted? When one or two of the element is absolutely not there. You know, either the water element is not there or the air element is not there. When one element or two elements are absolutely absent, then the place is said to be haunted. You know, we all have a store in a house which we very rarely open, right? Whenever we open that store, don't you feel claustrophobic? Don't you feel, you know, uneasiness? So what is that uneasiness? That is the flow of energy. That because that room is closed always, so the flow of energy is not there. As a result, you're feeling claustrophobic. So even our residences, you know, at least in the morning time, daytime, when the house has been cleaned, try and open all the doors and windows of the house. Let the energy flow happen. And you see, you know, there'll be a lot of harmony and happiness in the family. You know, say example, like a couple in living in a house and they always keep fighting. So the energy flow of that house will be very negative. You know, so it's very important that the energy circulates. If the energy flow is proper, then there will never be any sort of any, you know, emotional problems or even physical problems. So see, this is such a simple thing, you know, which we can do and really bring about harmony in the house.
Yes, Riddhi. I think now we got to know what is the difference between residential and commercial property and how we should select.
Correct.
So now tell me one thing. When it comes to apartment, we have to buy whatever is available.
Correct.
Some apartments are passed with 60% to 80%. How do we decide whether this apartment is good for us and how much we can compromise on it?
Okay. This is a very important question because now, you know, as I said, Vastu was written 5,000 years back. Then the kind of structures which were made were very different from the structures that we are living in now. You know, even if we have a big house, but then still the way we construct it is very different. Like in traditional vastu, in Vedic vastu, you know, it is written that, you know, the toilet should be really far. The kitchen and toilet should be really, you know, in different directions, which is not possible. Nowadays, you know, every bedroom, we need an attached bathroom, right? So, you know, we have to see vastu as well. So answering your question that, you know, what should we see while, you know, buying a property? So now one question that I get, you know, very often is that, you know, north facing property hai to achhi hai, south facing hai to bahut kharab hai. You know, this is one myth. I don't know from where it started, but then believe me, it's a myth. You know, I meet a lot of builders. I remember I visited Nagpur and there was this builder. He said, ma'am, south facing ke to bhav hi gir jate. You know, people, they are not interested. And let me share this with you. Mr. Bachchan has two houses and both the houses are south facing. So won't we love to have a south facing house? Okay. Anyways, so explaining you that what, you know, which direction. See, no direction is bad. Every direction has certain good qualities and certain not so good qualities. It is not ki north hai to everything will be good and south hai to everything will be bad. See, where did this come from? Try and understand the reason behind it. Since we're talking about the scientific aspect of vastu, our gods and goddesses, where do we place them? We place them in snow, na, in hilly areas. Shankar Bhagwan kahan rehte hain? Kailash Parvat pe rehte hain, wahan pe barf hoti hai. I remember my grandmother telling me, aise mat karo, nark mein jaoge to tumhe kadhai mein tala jayega. You know, we have these stories, you know, ki nark, for us, what are these stories? What do these stories tell? These stories are trying to tell that for us, for Indians, heat is hell and cool, coldness is heaven. If you hear the mythological stories of cold countries like Tibet and all, in I've read a couple of stories in which they describe that if you go, die and if you go to hell, you know, you will be tied with an ice slab or you will be, you know, put in an ice cave. So what does this mean? That for them, hell is cold and for them, warmth is heaven. Now, the sun rises in the east and sets in the west, travels via south. There is no sun in north for us people living in the northern hemisphere. That is why it is said that you should have a north facing property because you will not get the heat of sun. That is the logic. It's as simple as this. But then in India, we are blessed with different seasons. And in every season, every direction is good. Like in winter, south is very good, right? So when you're buying an apartment, please don't be confused about this direction is good or this direction is bad. No, every direction is good. And as I said, there are remedies that one can do without doing any structural changes. You can, you know, bring about do remedies which can do wonders. Now, one little thing that you have to take care is that for which vastu there is no remedy, that is there should be no toilet in the northeast direction. Because northeast is the Ishan cone. We, you know, generally say you should have a mandir in northeast. So there should not be a toilet in the northeast. This is just one thing that you have to, you know, kind of follow. Otherwise, everything has a remedy and everything is perfectly fine.
Good. Yeah. So tell me, normally master bedroom is in southwest.
Yeah.
But how good or bad if it's in northwest?
Okay. As I said, again, I'm repeating the same thing. No direction is good and no direction is bad. Southwest is the direction for relationship and for stability. Now, we were talking about, you know, harmony in the house. So if there is, you know, any, issues in your family you're facing, you know, where there are frictions between the family members or where there are tensions between the family members. So please put a family picture in the southwest direction. Put it in a golden frame and put it in the southwest direction and see, you know, there will be a lot of harmony in the family, especially for young married couples. I get to hear a lot of queries and this lockdown has added to all this that, you know, bahut jhagde ho rahe hain, bahut ladai ho rahi hai, I can't live with her, I can't live with him. Simple remedy. Take a golden frame, put your picture and put it in the southwest direction. This will really, you know, bring a bonding between the couple or the family members. So southwest direction is the direction for stability. It is also the direction for skills. You know, by skills, I mean, whatever you're doing, you know, suppose, for example, somebody doesn't has a bedroom in the southwest direction, then what? Then, you know, you can put your books or activities that you do, which, you know, you want really to enhance. Like to so many parents, I say, bachche agar nahi padhte, unka school bag southwest mein rakh do, apne aap padhne lag jayenge. Like, for example, like I take my own example. So in my southwest direction, in my house, there is no room. It's an open area. So I have kept my vastu books there so that my skill increases. So, you know, somebody who's pursuing maybe music or a sports. So, you know, they can keep their guitar or their badminton racket there. So it will help them in increasing their skills. So now, you know, southwest is the direction for enhancing your skills. So southwest direction bedroom is good. Northwest is the direction for support. Now, what do I mean by support? Support means support from anything, you know, support from the family, support from the staff you're working with, support from your bosses, support from your subordinates, right? Northwest direction should always be white in color, right? You should always be white or you can have yellow color in northwest direction. Please avoid blue color in northwest direction. Why? Because northwest, as I said, it is support. Support has to be stable. And stability is earth element. And blue color or water element is shaky. You know, water is moving. It is never still. So if you get water element or blue color in northwest, the support will go. Right? So if you want support, you know, if you feel that, you know, there is the support is lacking from somewhere in your, you know, from some spheres of your life, then that means there is some problem in the northwest, which you can rectify and bring the support. Now, coming answering to your question, ma'am, no direction is bad. If you have a bedroom in southwest, it is wonderful. If you have a bedroom in northwest, that is also equally good.
Great.
Yeah.
So, and you have explained it very well, Riddhi. Tell me, does Vastu apply to high-rise apartments?
Yeah, this is one question that of late I've been really getting because, you know, the apartments are becoming really high. Yes, it does. You know, a lot of people have this myth that, you know, since it's not touching the ground, you know, it's not in direct contact with the earth. So maybe Vastu is not applicable. But see, as I said, Vastu is about the five elements. So it is not just the earth element, you know, that is not there. It is the air also, the water also, the sky also, and that is there in this universe. Also, this, you know, the material you're using to make the house involves the earth element, right? The metals, you know, the metals also, we give a lot of importance and consideration to the metals. Metals also have a defined area, like brass is the metal for southwest direction, right? So metals also we use. So metals are also part of the earth element. So even if you're living in a high-rise apartment, say maybe you're living on the 50th floor, but earth element is there. So Vastu does applies to a person who's living on, you know, high, how high, you know, you might live, it will apply.
It will apply.
Yeah, so even if you go and live in Himalayas, it will apply, right?
Okay, great. So I think now, we got our answer, but still, what can be done for getting harmony and happiness in the house?
Okay, yes, yes. This is one question and this is a real concerning question because we all want happiness in the house. We all want, you know, that when we come back home, you know, people, everybody should be happy and cheerful, right? So see, one thing is that, as I said, that you should keep your doors and windows open. Basically, there has to be a flow of energy, right? Apart from that, you know, if you can light camphor, because camphor has a lot of, apart from having a lot of medicinal values, it has, you know, properties which, you know, kind of, you know, relaxes your brain, right? And camphor has been given a lot of importance in the scriptures also. For Havan and all also, it is said that you should always use camphor. So lighting a camphor in a place where, you know, you'll be sitting, like, say, a common area or a living room will always do good to, you know, the family members. Also try and see that, you know, you should not clutter your house too much. This is a very simple tip, but then people don't follow it. You know, we make our houses, you know, go down or a storage place, especially nowadays when we have box beds. I see so many people, you know, just stuffing in the stuff there. See, please remember the bed is very important because that is where you're sleeping. You know, you're spending 8 hours of your day there. Your thinking, your, you know, communication, everything is happening on the bed. It's very important. So please don't put stuff that you're not using inside your bed as a storage, because that will impact your thinking and that will certainly impact your relationship. This is very, very important. Right? Especially broken things. Like I remember, you know, I went and did Vastu at a place where this couple was constantly fighting and they were on the verge of a divorce. You know, two things that I found there. One, they had a lot of mirrors, right? Mirrors also, the mirrors were like kind of cut in between. The design was such. Now in Vastu, we give a lot of importance to mirrors. Why? See, whenever there is a mirror, it is natural for us, we look at the mirror, don't we? Suppose there's a mirror here and I'm crossing. I look, you know, how am I looking? Now, suppose there's one more mirror here. I look here, I look here, I look here, I look here. What will happen? It will lead to confusions. Right? So therefore, it is said that you should not just randomly put mirror anywhere in the house and never put two mirrors opposite each other. And that is what I advise to, you know, couples who have children who are studying, that please avoid putting a mirror in a kid's room because it is a very big distraction. It is so obvious, you know, a kid is, as it is growing, he or she is, as it is conscious of their appearance, if they have a mirror, they'll keep looking again and again into it. Right? So you should never have too many mirrors. You should never have two mirrors opposite each other because that also affects the relationship because it leads to confusion. Then whenever you put a design, please keep a simple design rather than having, you know, a lot of curves, a lot of arcs. Why? Again, that will lead to confusion. Now, as I was describing about this couple, so one thing that I noticed was a mirror. Second thing was that under the bed, the box bed, they had kept all their family members' shoes. There were some 80, 70 shoes inside the bed. They had stored that way. So I just told them to remove the shoes, remove the mirrors, and touch wood, things are absolutely fine. Right? So small things like, you know, you should always have fresh flowers in the house. Never put artificial flowers. you know, as that also affects the relationship. Never have, you know, things which have sharp edges. Never keep weapons. Why not to keep weapons? Because, you know, that brings in aggression in you, right? So these are the small things that, you know, you should avoid, and they can really do wonders for bringing in harmony in the house.
True.
Yeah.
So tell me, does kitchen need a definitely area of direction?
Well, see, to be very honest, southeast and south-southeast is the area where the kitchen should ideally be.
But southeast then, and?
Southeast and south-southeast. Okay. See, I should have said this in the beginning, but I'm just telling you now that in Vastu, we just don't follow the four directions. We divide the four into eight and eight into further 16. So ideally, after every 11 degree, the direction changes. Right. So like, say, between east to north, there will be four directions. Right. So like this, southeast and south southeast is the direction, ideal direction where the kitchen should be.
Rizzi, yeah. When we say south southeast, so yeah. How it is different than southeast?
Ma'am, it is an extension of southeast only.
Okay. Right?
As I said, that since it's a 11 degree, you know, so the 22 degree of southeast, I'm sorry, I'm being a little technical, but then 22 degree of southeast is the ideal zone where the kitchen should be, right?
Now, so when we talk of kitchen, so yeah. you mean the burner placement, or you need the location of kitchen?
Yeah, I'm just coming to that. I'll explain you that. As I said, you know, and you also had mentioned that what about apartments? Now, in an apartment, we cannot choose, you know, that the kitchen be in the southeast. Right? We don't have that choice. So it's okay. You know, even if you don't have a kitchen in the southeast, that's perfectly fine. That's not an issue. Only direction we avoid when you go to check apartment, you know, from Vastu point of view, just see that there should be no kitchen in north. Why? Yeah. Again, I'll come to the basics, because north is water element. Kitchen is where the cooking has to happen. It is the fire element. So if you get, you know, water, you got fire and water, what will happen? As I said, north is the zone for money. North is the zone for opportunity. It is a zone for health. So all these factors will get affected, right? Now, answering your question, that is it just the burner or the entire kitchen? So firstly, we certainly see the entire kitchen. But then, yes, the position of the burner is more important, and the most important rather, right? Because ultimately the cooking is happening there, and the fire element as per se is there. Now, I like to add one more thing. A lot of people ask me that, okay, kitchen ka ideal direction is southeast, but in the kitchen there is water also, because obviously for cooking you need water. So that means you're contradicting. No, it's not. So it's not contradiction. Right? We have water, but it's not that, you know, we have water in abundance. It's just a tap which we need for cooking. And ideally for cooking, you need water. You cannot do cooking without water. Right? So it is not a contradiction. A lot of people have this myth. Right? So if your kitchen is in the southeast, wonderful. For people who don't have their kitchen in the southeast, please don't get disappointed. There's nothing to be worried about. Right?
So now you just told about the tap, water tap.
Yeah.
So if the water tap is not placed in north, because yeah. depend how is the burner, how yeah, they have yeah, made yeah. the kitchen. So yeah. that tap is not important. It can be in any direction.
It can be in any direction, ma'am. That's not an issue. That's not an issue. See, when we see Vastu, we see of the entire, you know, apartment. Right. So we divide these zones. Like a lot of people ask me, like kitchen mein ye north hai. We don't see an individual room or an individual. We see the entire, you know, the structure. That what are the directions in which the entire structure is followed. That is more important.
Great. So yeah. tell me, if there is any loss in business or going through a difficult time
yeah.
in business, can Vastu help in this condition?
Yes. Yes, absolutely. It can help. It can help in a very, very big way. Like I just give a small example of that, you know, water dispenser, which I changed, you know, there are so many examples like this where, you know, people were suffering losses, or, you know, they were on the verge of closing the business. And, you know, when I intervened and I did Vastu, and there were, you know, amazing results. I'll give you a very small example. Again, this was of a client in Bombay, and he had just moved in an apartment, and within 15 days, he had a brain stroke. And his condition was really very critical. So anyways, he came out of it. And when he came, so, you know, you know how apartments, especially in Bombay, are, they're really very small in size. You don't have much space where you can do stuff. So just by changing the placement of the bed, you know, from the one wall to the other wall, you know, it's been 3 years and he's completely fine. you know, so small changes like this. Now, talking about losses, you know, as I'm again and again saying that, you know, north is the direction for money. Southeast is the direction for recovery of money. West is the direction for profitability. ठीक है, मुझे मौका मिल गया, मेरे पैसे भी रिकवर हो गए, पर पैसे आते नहीं है, उससे पहले खर्चा हो जाता है. यू नो दिस हैपेंस विद मोस्ट ऑफ अस. यू नो, वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग सम पेमेंट, सपोज वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग 100 rupees एंड देयर इज अ एक्सपेंस ऑफ 200 rupees. ऑल्सो वेस्ट ऑफ साउथ वेस्ट, राइट, द डायरेक्शन बिटवीन वेस्ट एंड साउथ वेस्ट इज वेस्ट ऑफ साउथ वेस्ट, दैट इज द जोन फॉर सेविंग्स. सो इफ यू कीप योर लॉकर देयर, देयर विल बी लॉट ऑफ सेविंग्स. Now suppose you don't have a room or the area is such, like in my own house, I have a dining area there. Then what do you do? So just remember this very important tip. In west of southwest, keep a cream color, that is an off-white color piggy bank or a gullak, and keep some money in it. You'll start saving money. Right? Also, like, you know, your property papers or, you know, any other important thing which you really want to save. So please keep there. It'll always be saved. Or you want to enhance, you want to grow, you know, you want to invest in more property, your share papers, everything, you know, keep it in the west of southwest. You won't believe it. It's just few days back and my father-in-law was trading, you know, in stocks. And I told him, you know, please sit here. The day he sat there, he made a profit of 3 lakhs. So, you know.
Good, great.
Now anything he does, he'll ask me, Riddhi, I'm going to sit here.
Very nice.
Small little things like this can really bring in a lot of difference. And also adding to this, if a businessman has a bedroom in the west, it is very good for him.
Okay.
Right. So that answers your question to southwest and northwest. So if it is west, yes, you'll make a lot of profit.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
So there are so many issues like relationship, bonding between couples.
Yeah.
Can Vastu help to improve their relationship?
Yes, absolutely, absolutely. Again, I would repeat, southwest is the direction for bonding. And northeast is the direction for clarity. You know, whenever there's a conflict, not just between couples, maybe between you and your parents, between partners, what is it leads to? What is it, where does it start from? It starts from confusion. There is no clarity in mind, right? So northeast is the zone for clarity. You know, that is why they said you should do meditation sitting there. You should have a mandir there. Why? Because when you sit in a mandir, you'll focus. You know, that focus is there. With focus, you get clarity. That is why they said, you know, northeast, even if kids' room is there, it is wonderful. Or, you know, if kids study areas in the northeast, that's very, very good. But apart from that, you know, even if you know, you're working, you're doing something and you feel, you know, I'm not getting the right ideas or I'm really very confused, to sit in the northeast for some time and do. You know, you'll really get good ideas. So, you know, there is conflict issues between, you know, a couple, make them sit in the northeast direction and tell them, talk to each other. They will get that clarity, right? That is one thing, right? Another thing is, as I said, southwest direction, put a family picture, put a couple picture in the southwest. Again, southwest is a earth element. Please don't get any water body or blue color in southwest. Nahi to it will lead to relationship issues. You can have yellow because yellow represents earth, or golden color there. That will really enhance, you know, the relationship between the couple. There will always be one. Right?
Yeah. Good. So can we have a toilet in Brahmasthan?
Well, see, to be very honest, ma'am, nowadays we are talking about apartments. In an apartment, how do you determine a Brahmasthan? Right? It is very difficult to determine a Brahmasthan. Now, as I said, when Vastu was written some 5,000 years back, then the way the things were constructed was very different than the way the construction is done now. Now, we did this research, you know, where we took we studied floor plans of more than 500 to 600 houses. And we found out, you know, that if there is a problem in the Brahmasthan, the property will not be constructed. The construction will not get complete, or something or the other will happen. You know, Brahmasthan defect is a big defect. Wo banega hi nahi. You know, you must have seen a lot of places or a lot of properties. Aray, bade achhi location pe hai, par ye to khatam hi nahi hui. Aray, iska to kaam beech mein atak gaya, builder ko kuch ho gaya. There can be any reason, but the property will not be constructed if there is a Brahmasthan issue. Right? So ideally, Brahmasthan in apartments to hota hi nahi hai, because, you know, it comes in the open or whatever, you know. So it is not an, there is a toilet in Brahmasthan, so, you know, there will be some structural conditions only. Usme wo complete hi nahi ho payegi. Agar aapko already constructed hai aur toilet hai aur Brahmasthan mein aapko lag raha hai, to koi problem nahi hai. Don't panic about it.
Good. So is a shoe rack, normally we all have a shoe rack in front of our door.
Yeah.
So the shoe rack, if we have a shoe rack in north opposite main door, is that okay?
See, generally we say we avoid that having a shoe rack in the north. But then as I said, we have limited choice. In that case, it is always better that you have a covered shoe rack. So it is not visible, you know, that is better. That is perfectly fine. And also, I would like to tell you one thing, you know, this is a secret, but I'm sharing with all of you. Until and unless there is no problem, please don't worry about it. Maybe you have a toilet in the Brahmistan or you have a toilet in the Northeast. If you're not facing any problem, then it's okay. Perfectly fine. Right?
Very true.
A lot of sweet. And still, if I don't get diabetic, then why do I hassle? Right?
Very true, Riddhi. So I have been getting questions from our members. So I'm asking you one by one in between.
Yeah, yeah, please.
So
please.
Is an animal statue in the house good?
See, animal statue, animal painting is still okay. But statue, why? You know, because in earlier times, you know, people would go for shikar and they would have those skins and that animal. So, you know, it is something not a very good thing. You know, if you see, it is something barbaric, you know, killing an animal and, you know, bringing, putting the skin and all. Although, you know, a lot of people argue then people eat non-veg also, you know, they're doing the same thing then also. Well, yes, that is there. But then it is always better that, you know, you should not have, you know, even for leather products, it is said that you should avoid because it is ultimately, you know, skin of a dead animal, you know, so you should not be having. So if, you know, just if a statue is made of clay, or you know, ceramic or something, it's not bad. In fact, for vastu remedies, you know, we tell, you know, putting a pair of red horses in the southeast direction will always, there will always be flow of money, right? So again, this is a tip. Putting a pair of red horses in the southeast direction, there will be flow of money. Similarly, putting a pair of white horses in the northwest direction, you will always get the support. Lot of women are here and lot of women come and ask me, staff nahi rehta, maid bhag jati hai, servant ka issue hai, kya karein? Northwest ko proper karo, problem solve ho jayegi.
So we should place the picture of a pair of horses.
Yeah. If you can put a statue, nothing like it. If not statue, even, you know, white horses, painting will do.
White one. You just said the pink one for the south.
The red one for the southeast and white one for the north, northwest.
So that's very important because it's related to servants.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now I got another question.
This is like if, of today's session.
So if it's in a factory, which direction should the owner and family sit for prosperity?
Okay. So again, answering that, as I said in the beginning, what is the factory about? What is it to manufacture? You know, like somebody, as I said, you know, somebody's into food, it'll be different. Somebody's into metal, it'll be different. Somebody owning a garment will be different. So entirely depends on what area of work you are into. As per that, we determine the direction.
So it varies from person to person and
it varies from profession to profession, ma'am. Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. Kehte na kehte, hume ye cheez suit nahi kari. Right? Yeah. तो वो इसीलिए कि आप जो काम कर रहे थे अगर उसके डायरेक्शन के हिसाब से बैठे तो वो चीज आपको सूट कर जाती
है. So tell me, Riddhi, does Vastu has a connection with astrology?
Absolutely, absolutely. That's why I did both. Na? Anyways, it does because see, both Vastu and astrology have been a part of our Indian culture. Vastu and astrology both comes from India. The other sciences, you know, have not been part of India. Even palmistry comes from India. Other sciences have come from outside, right? Mm-hmm. So it does has a connection because astrology also deals with the five elements like Vastu. And it also deals about you know, how these five elements has an impact on us. So astrology and Vastu go together a long way. Yeah.
Good. So now you tell us, give us some tips for our students also.
Oh, yes. You know, I know, you know, mothers especially freak out more than, you know, what will happen to the children. Now, as I said, for children, like suppose they are young children, you know, in their pre-teens or less than 10 years and all, please don't have a window. Please don't have a mirror in their room, especially a big mirror. Now, suppose if you want to put a mirror, either you can have in the washroom or keep it in the cupboard, you know, put it in the cupboard such a way that when they need it, they can open it and use it. And when they don't need it, they can close it. Right, that will be better. Don't have a mirror which is visible because that will, you know, really create confusions and make them very conscious of themselves, right? also, see, in Vastu, the principle is whatever you see, you perceive that, you know. So please, like, I remember going to a, you know, friend's house to do Vastu, and she had a 5-year-old daughter, and she said she doesn't do anything. She just closes her room. She's inside her room, and, you know, she doesn't plays outside. She has no friends. So I saw the room. So the whole room looked like a Barbie land, you know, with all those pink stuff everywhere, dolls and the makeup kit and stuff like that, you know. So please avoid all this. Whatever, you know, you want your child to pursue, please have that. Another thing, talking about Vastu, southwest, as I said, is the direction for skills. So maybe the child's room is not in the southwest, you know, maybe somebody else's room is in the southwest, but then still, whatever the child is pursuing, if he keeps that thing in the southwest, it will help him develop that. You know, like I said, if you're playing guitar, so keep your guitar in the southwest. If you're playing badminton, keep your badminton rackets in the southwest. So that will really help you. Another thing, like, I'm talking a lot about colors. Now in kids' room, you know, again, color depends on the direction, but then in the kids' room, please don't keep put too bright colors, you know, also bright lights, you know, because lights and bright colors add to aggression, especially in teenagers. When as it is, they're aggressive, adding bright colors and bright light will make them more aggressive, and they will lose their focus and concentration. Also in kids' room, please don't have, you know, like it is a fashion these days and it looks nice also, that two different walls have two different contrasting colors, right? Again, in a kid's room, I would advise, please don't do that. Have a same color. If you want to, you know, add a different element, then try to make it in pastels or light colors, because then that will have an impact on their mind. They'll be calm, they'll be cool, they'll be able to focus, right? As I said, west of southwest is the zone for savings, right? That is also the zone for education. Now, children who are trying for, you know, higher studies, like, you know, somebody is pursuing to become an IAS, or somebody is trying for a, you know, Ivy League university. So if they sit in that direction and study, or if they keep their direct books in that direction, they will really achieve, you know, what they aspire for. West, I'm repeating west. Earlier, I was talking about west of southwest. Now I'm talking about west. West, which is the direction for profitability, is also the direction for manifestation. So whatever desires you have, take a white paper, write on it, put it in a white envelope, and put it in the west direction. Your desires will be fulfilled.
Great.
Right? Yeah.
Okay, please continue.
Yeah. So that's it, ma'am. Yeah. You can ask.
Abhi, like when we see some apartment, like you also said, we can rectify, we can solve that problem. Like I remember sometimes Vastu people, they say, ma'am, don't worry. Hum log yahan se thoda khod ke iske andar pearl dal denge, thoda ye dal denge, wo kar denge, and this problem will be solved. So that's not, so does that really work?
No. To be very honest, no. As I said in the beginning, that's why I said in the beginning, because I get a lot of queries, a lot of people come to me, you know, and a lot of, initially when I started doing this, ma'am, see, being an astrologer, I wear no rings, neither do I recommend, neither do I wear. So, you know, I used to get this feedback, ki ye to bahut bekar astrologer hai, to koi upay hi nahi batati hai. You know, so people feel, you know, that you, until unless you don't tell something like dramatic like this, then you are no, you're not a proper, you know, person to consult. But then, ma'am, as I said, you know, there is a solution, but, and also that solution is very logical. You know, like I said, a child is not studying. Uska bag southwest direction mein rakh do, apne aap padhne lagega. Ab usme main aap se kahun, you know, put some pearls inside your house, or put, you know, dig your house, put some gold strip in your house, that will help. No, it doesn't help.
It doesn't help. But like you said now, ki maine us south se bacche ka bag udhar rakh diya, it helps. Exactly. Okay. So exactly. Same thing, sub west side pe, if it is light. So they say you put some wrought iron bars there and this.
No, it doesn't help. But then, yes, answering that, having said that, there are metals also which have directions. Like, you know, brass is the direction for southwest direction, we say use brass products, you know. Like for north, we say aluminium. So suppose say your house is north facing. So if you have an aluminium gate there, it'll do good. You should not have a brass gate there, right? Stuff like this certainly agree, certainly, you know, add to the value of Vastu and all. But not stuff like this, ki pearl dal do. Even crystals and pyramids, as a matter of fact, ma'am. See, when Vastu was written, there was nothing like crystals and pyramids. It's just, these are more marketing gimmicks, you know.
Okay. सो दैट थिंग डूइंग एनीथिंग विद दैट अपार्टमेंट कि यहाँ पे ये चेंज कर दें या कोई भी प्रॉपर्टी है उसको हैवी कर दें उसको लाइट कर दें दैट डजंट वर्क
नहीं हैवी एंड लाइट मैटर्स बट देन बाय डूइंग हैवी एंड लाइट यू नो व्हाट यू लाइक साउथ वेस्ट हैज टू बी हैवी नाउ इन एन अपार्टमेंट विद द कंस्ट्रक्शन इज ऑलरेडी बीन डन वी कैन नॉट यू नो मेक चेंज द वेट ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर हाउ वी कैन मेक योर अपार्टमेंट हैवी बाय प्लेसिंग द हैवी फर्नीचर दैट साइड Right? North, you keep your north. They say north should be light. You know, it should not be heavy. So don't keep much heavy stuff that side. Also, you know, like I've done this as a remedy, you know, put some pictures or paintings of say heavy mountains in the southwest. Yeah. That makes it heavy. Right? If you want to put a picture of a flowing water, put it in the north direction. You know, that will be good. That will again attract a lot of money.
So that all works.
Yeah, that works. That works, certainly.
That works. So a lot of confusion now we all are clear about it. And now I'm sure that all our viewers cannot wait to go around their home and put into practice everything they have learned today. So before that, I would like to ask you, Riddhi, can we consult you on the phone?
Absolutely.
And do you go out of town to visit the property?
Yes, not just out of town, out of the country as well. Because as I said, Vastu is applicable all over because everything is made of the five elements and five elements are there in the entire earth that we're living in. So yes, absolutely. You can connect with me over the phone. I do give consultation for Vastu and for astrology.
Great.
Yeah.
So thank you so much, Riddhi. And now I hand it over to Anita to give vote of thanks.
Riddhi, this has been such an interesting webinar. I know people are going to keep watching it again and again because the way you were talking, it was like it was just at the tip of your tongue. But we need to actually, you know, sit down and write all the directions that you did and all. So I'm sure we all are going to be watching this webinar again and again to get the directions right and all. And, you know, the surprising thing was that commercial vastu is so different profession to profession. I mean, this is the first time I've heard of something like this. I mean, I thought, you know, like for a business, it is this one direction is right for every kind of profession. But you've clarified that. And you said that if there are couples who are having a, you know, a problem and they're this thing, and you just open the doors and windows and let energy flow, how will that help the couple to resolve their issue?
See, like as I said, you know, that it's not just related to couples, it's related to all the family members. Like, you know, it happens within the family members, you know, there are frictions, there is tension, you know, maybe like you fight with your son or you fight with your daughter, you know, it happens. So what happens is that the energy is, you know, forms an aura around us. You know, the aura we have is the way we behave and the way we talk. So therefore, it is said that, you know, if that energy flows away, you know, it becomes, the atmosphere of that place becomes better. You know, so but if the energy bottles up, then that will lead further to the problem to aggravate, right? So we don't want the problem to increase more. Now again, Anita ji, having said that, this is a basic and a general tip. Again, it depends on what kind of issues are they facing, and then yes, Vastu has an answer and a solution to that also.
Well, that's great to hear. Yeah. Okay, now talking about supposing you go to buy a plot. I mean, one thing we've always heard, yes, not south, you know, the shouldn't be south facing. Another thing is Vagmukhi plot. I mean, where does that come in?
Yeah, so there are two plots. One is called as Shermukhi and one is called as Gaimukhi, Gaumukhi they say. So the Gaumukhi one is, you know, narrower at the entrance and broadens at the end. And with the Shermukhi, it is vice versa. So it is said that, you know, it is written in the text of Vastu also, that, you know, Shermukhi plot, which widens at the end, you know, is better. Widens at the beginning, you know, at the entrance, that is Shermukhi, is better for a commercial entity. And a Gaumukhi is better for a residential. But then again, as I said, you know, so much has changed from the time these texts were written, right? So much has changed, you know. So one cannot just blindly follow these rules. One has to apply the practical, you know, the practicality. One has to see the practicality. One has to see, you know, there are a lot of things that one has to see while considering Vastu. So yes, these things are written and they do have an impact, but it's not that, you know, if you have a Shermukhi, it's going to do all good only to you. Or if you don't have a Shermukhi, it's going to do all bad. No, it is just 1% of the entire Vastu that we see.
That's great. I mean, these are all misconceptions that have been floating around for such a long time. And I think all of us just assume that is the truth, you know, and we are blindly following it without really knowing.
And Google adds further to the confusion.
Google, of course. Another thing also that is said that you should not have a plot, I mean, for a bungalow or commercial use on a crossroad or three roads?
Yeah, it is said that at a dead end, you should not have, you know, at a T point, you should not have. Yes. See, I'll tell you what the logic is. Like, you know, I asked about that shoe rack in the north. I said, cover it. Hmm. Right. Now, what happens at a dead end or a T point? You know, there are chances of an accident because one person is coming from here, one person is coming from here. They might collide. And what these Vastu, you know, people do, what remedy do they give for dead end or T point is put a mirror. Now, that's not a remedy. That's logic and common sense. You know, the mirror is there. You can see the traffic. So, therefore, there will be no accident. This is the whole idea, right? This is the reason.
That's so true. Yeah. You also said that lighting a camphor is very good. But I've also heard, and this now, in fact, it's quite this thing that even if you keep a bowl of camphor,
yeah,
it actually helps to clear the energy of a space. Is that correct?
Absolutely. Camphor, not just camphor. Even, you know, as a matter of fact, even cow dung. You know, that is also very useful. If you see in olden times, you know, people would dry it and keep it. Now Ramdev is selling it like hotcakes, right? But anyways, but yes, all these things, you know, which we get from nature are very helpful, you know. They all have health benefits. And camphor, in fact, I know people, you know, who dissolve camphor and drink it, you know, because it helps in building immunity also. But it has to be pure, you know. So camphor certainly is very good. It's a kind of a wonder thing, you know, putting a camphor and lighting it.
You also spoke about not having too many mirrors in a bedroom or not having too many mirrors around your house. And it's also said that at least where your bed is, you shouldn't have a mirror in front of your bed. Is that also part of Vastu?
Well, see,
when you wake up, you don't look into a mirror.
Yeah. Again, the thing is that, see, there are two things to this, I would say. One is mirror depends on which direction. Mirror is a water element. So you should not ideally have a very big mirror in the south. Now, a lot of people ask ki entrance pe mirror laga le. You know, it is not that entrance pe mirror laga lo ya nahi laga, but you need to know the direction of the entrance. If you have a north entrance, you put a mirror, it'll do very good. But if you have a south entrance, then don't put a mirror. Right? Depends on that. So that is one thing. So same thing applies for a bedroom. If you have a north bedroom, it is fine. If you have a south bedroom, then put it in a different angle. Right? Now, asking about bed, that you should not have it in front of a bed. Yes, certainly. Because it will so happen that, you know, you'll keep looking there. Your focus will be more there, you know, rather than focusing on yourself or, you know, your partner or whatever, you know. So that's why they say that, you know, if you have a mirror in front of a bed, it'll lead to arguments. So obviously, when you're, you know, focusing in the mirror only, it will lead to arguments.
That's a good one.
That's a sensible way of putting it, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay, another thing you spoke about, that there shouldn't be weapons in the house. But I mean, as you're saying, Vastu is a science which is 5,000 years old. And like you spoke about those dead skin animals, you know, where they used to go hunting and then stretch the animal skin and place it on the wall. So at that time, what actually seen a lot of palaces and all, they used to have those swords and that shield, you know, which used to be on the walls. So, I mean, is that contradicting the Vastu?
Absolutely. I absolutely agree with you. See, even in, you know, if you read the traditional Vastu, where I said there are 16 directions, so these 16 directions, 16 rooms were made, you know, 16 rooms were defined. So one of the room was the arms room, you know, that storeroom where they used to keep the arms. These were mere display things, you know. But even for the display things, there are certain areas which are absolutely prohibited, that even you should not be displaying arms there. Right? And nowadays, you know, see, earlier there was no concept of box beds. Now there's a concept of box bed. And things we don't want people to see, we hide them under them. Maybe, you know, if you possess a weapon, you know, you might, you know, put it under the box bed, which is not the right thing to do. You know, in Vastu, there is an area called as Kop Bhavan. You know, they've written, you know, that south-southwest is Kop Bhavan. What is Kop Bhavan? So when in earlier times, when the queens used to be unhappy or they would cry or something, so that area was designed for them to go and cry in that area. So nowadays in modern context, we say it is a zone of depression. Why? Because you go and cry in that area, right? So ideally you should have a toilet in that area because, you know, everything flushes off.
Oh, that's great.
That is the idea.
That's really great. Okay, now when you talk about, you spoke about apartments, you know, which is on one level. What if the bungalow has a ground plus one? Then, you know, what about the directions? Where should be what? And so you again go according to what you have told us?
Yes, absolutely. So how many floors you might have? It might be an individual house which has, say, five floors. See, the directions remain the same, na?
Correct.
Right? So when we do vastu, especially for a residential, like I said, for commercial vastu, we see what profession you are in. In commercial residential vastu, we see what is the family size, what is the age group of the people, you know, what is the activity. Now for a newly married couple, the room, you know, the area for their room will be different for an elderly couple or for a student who's studying. Like when I talked about students, I said, you know, for a pre-teens, a different direction. For people, you know, kids who are pursuing some skills, a different direction. For kids, you know, who want to aspiring to go out of the country or, you know, doing higher studies, for them direction is different. So entirely depends, you know, that what is the age group of people and what activities are being conducted. Also, this was one question I was expecting, which I did not get from you guys, is that what if I have an office in my own residence? Then,
correct.
You know, a lot of people ask me this also, you know, work from home is what is happening nowadays. Now, for that also, there are designated directions. What happens nowadays? You sit on the dining table, you take the laptop on the bedroom, you go to the, you know, drawing room. It should not be that way. Again, see, northeast, I said, is the direction for clarity. So you should be sitting in the northeast direction. Then southwest, suppose, you know, which I said is the direction for skills. Now, suppose your work involves marketing or, you know, you have to make some presentation. So here, so sit in the southwest direction and then do that. Right? Suppose you are into consultation, you know, then do sitting in the north will do well to you. Like I'm right now sitting in the north.
Great tip that you've given us. Okay, yeah. One question that comes to my mind. You've done Vastu and astrology. What about numerology? How important is numerology in, you know, assigning prosperity and love and happiness and all? I mean, like, you know, normal thing is that you shouldn't have a house which is 8 number.
Do you believe
in numerology?
Yeah. People do. Yeah, I know. So see, as I said, you know, I'm a very patriotic person. For me, India is very important. So, you know, these sciences are Indian sciences and I've been really following them. And as you know, it comes with my blood also, because my great grandfather was into it. So as I said, these Vastu, astrology, palmistry has always been a part of our culture, you know, and three of these sciences are very scientific, although I don't do palmistry. Whereas in talking about numerology, talking about tarot, talking about feng shui, they came from different parts of the world. Doesn't mean that they are not sciences. Certainly, they are also sciences, you know. But then, as I say, you know, the mother of all occult sciences is astrology, right? So with these sciences, the only drawback is that they are very limited. You know, they have limitations. Whereas with our sciences, there are no limitations. You can go on exploring, you know, and they cover each and every aspect of life. Whereas with numerology and with tarot, you know, they are very limited, you know. That is the difference. Although I do numerology also, but then yes, certainly since I do it, so I know better that it has certain limitations.
That's great to hear, Riddhi. Last question before we wind up for the day. Looking at the pandemic situation around, what would be the one best tip that you would give everyone? You know, everyone's business, the economy is falling, businesses are really, you know, in a disharmony. So what is the one good tip you would give for people in general?
So, because nowadays people are very, very depressed. And again, you know, money opportunities, as I said, you know, people are really losing their jobs. Businesses are also going stagnant. So people are really worried about, they want more work coming their way, more opportunities coming their way. So this is a very important tip. Please note it down. In the north, you know, wherever there is 0 degree north in your house, put a green picture there. You will get a lot of opportunities.
Or the green bottle with that money plant.
That is, that you have to keep in the north. Again, that is to attract money. This one is to attract opportunities coming your way.
Oh, wow. That's a fabulous tip, I'm sure.
So you mean to say green plant also?
Green money plant in a green bottle is separate. That you have to keep. That is to attract money. This specific thing I said is to attract opportunity coming your way, is put a green picture. A green painting or a green photo. It should not be very small. It has to be, significantly little visible, right? Put it on the north wall.
Oh, great. That's a great tip. I've also heard that having a picture of running horses in your office sort of gets you a lot of opportunities.
See, for running horses, as I said, you know, there are directions. If you keep a pair of running horses, especially red color in the southeast, yes, it's going to be good. Again, you know, you're getting recovery of money happens. Money is there. Then having white horses in the northwest direction is good. Not randomly can you put it anywhere. You know, Vastu C is all about directions. So you need to keep the right things at the right directions. That's it. And as you rightly said, you know, there are a lot of things which are going around, and then Google adding further to it. It says, ye rakh lo. Kahan rakh lo, ye nahi pata. So people really don't know where and what and how.
So keeping turtles in the house, that's also lucky.
Turtles, yes. Turtles is more a feng shui tip than a vastu tip.
Riddhi, I got a question that what is the best location for Buddha statue?
Northeast.
Sorry?
Northeast.
Northeast. Okay, great.
So thank you so much, Riddhi. It's been a pleasure having you over. And like I mentioned just a few minutes back, I know people are going to keep watching this webinar again and again to pick up all the tips that you've given us. Thank you for being with us here today.
Yes, thank you, Riddhi.
Wonderful.
Thank you so much for mine. And I hope whatever information I shared made sense, because that was the objective of the whole session.
Oh, it did. It did. Trust me, it did. And thank you, Kamini, for moderating the session. Thank you very much. And thank you, viewers, for being with us live today on Facebook. Good day to all of you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.